Welcome to Dermatology. Here we'll take a look at inflammatory disorders. Our topic first, we'll begin with general terminology. It would behoove you to spend a little bit of time to make sure that you have a proper understanding of the following descriptions. You will see these descriptions either being described by your attending or in a clinical vignette, and this will then clue you in as to what kind of dermatologic condition you're referring to. For example, if it's a macule, you cannot feel this. So therefore, you place your hand on the macule, for example, cafe au lait spot. It's a macule, it's mocha colored. By definition, less than 1 centimeter, that is not palpable. That is the most important topic. Patch is a lesion that's a little bit greater than 1 centimeter. And once again, that is not palpable. But both of these are not palpable, but the size with the macule is a little bit smaller. Once I get into papules, well, these are elevations, and so therefore it is possible that you're able to feel these, but the elevation here is less than 1 centimeter. Or you might have a patient that has a condition we'll talk about called psoriasis. In psoriasis, this is a plaque, and this would be flat-topped elevation. You've heard of salmon-colored plaque with psoriasis, and here the elevation would be greater than 1 centimeter. A nodule. With nodule, I want you to think of something like a rheumatoid nodule or subcutaneous nodule that you might find with the criteria, Jones criteria for rheumatic fever. And so therefore, a nodule will be round and with an elevation of less than 1 centimeter. Whereas if it's a tumor, and remember a tumor, all it means is a swelling. And if it's a particular tumor or swelling that has not developed due to perhaps injury or trauma, then you're looking at an elevation of greater than 2 centimeters. Then we get into what's known as fluid filled. Now, what kind of fluid is then filling up your particular lesion? You've heard of herpes, you've heard of chickenpox or varicella. This is referring to your vesicle. It's a clear fluid, blister. You've heard of painful blisters that may occur with a condition, a porphyria pathway disease known as porphyrocutaneous tarda, where that type of vesicle would then be painful in your patient upon exposure to UV light. And here the blister is less than 1 centimeter. A pustule. I said pustule on purpose because here you're going to have fluid that's filling up this blister, which is made up of pus. And we'll say pus less than 1 centimeter, and this is what you're referring to. Bulle. A bulle, when we get into our what's known as your vesiculo bulbous, or in other words, your bullous type of conditions, pemphigoid vulgaris or bulle pemphigoid. A bulle is going to be fluid filled as well, but a little bit larger, greater than 1 centimeter in diameter. And you have erosions. Well, with an erosion, it's loss of part of the epidermis. Part. Erosion. Whereas if it's an ulcer that you're going to then notice on the skin, then please understand that the full thickness of loss of the epidermis. The fine difference between erosion and ulcer becomes important to you in terms of description.